Hello, let's look at data and information in the designing and evaluation of planning strategies. Now, let's look at the difference between data and information. Difference, talking about data, we are looking at the raw facts that you want to collect. If you are looking at the facts you want to collect, and the information will be after you have processed the facts, it becomes an information. Now, what is the difference between data and information? Importance of data and information. In this regard, we have to look at you use data and information in designing and evaluating planning strategies. Remember, the data itself, for example, you have school age, or the enrollment of students in school, or your demographical factor of students in school. You take their age, you take their parental background or family background, then you can take their state and so on. The cells could equally be taken. These are data, but that data may not be found useful until it is now processed into an information. And what you need to do is to subject that data you have collected. You use analysis, you now analyze using statistics to analyze it, and after it has been analyzed, could be found useful as an information. And how will it be? For example, you can say, well, in a particular state, you have this number of female or male registered students in a particular setting, or you have this age group of students that are registered, you have this age group that are left out. So the data you have collected will now enhance you to get the right information. Also, let us look at the type of data and information required in designing and evaluating a implementation strategy. One of such information that is required is the qualitative school and classroom-wise data. When you're talking about the qualitative school and classroom-wise wise data, what are we referring to? For example, you want to know the amount of class time spent on a structure. How many minutes, how many hours do you spend on a particular subject in a day or in a week? They want to know the type and amount of homework assigned by grade. You want to find out the provision made for acceleration and remediation. When you are doing promotion, and for those that could not be promoted, what do you do to them? Are they to repeat? Are they to withdraw? Or are those some of them, you feel okay, if you can spend this number of time in a particular class, you could move to the next one. You have to find out the provision made for class coverage when a teacher is absent. When there is no teacher in the class, especially whereby you have a teacher assigned to a class, especially in the primary school, if the teacher is not available, what happens to that class? Who takes care of the class? Is there any provision made for it? Teachers with other jobs, then what are the provisions? Do you allow part-time teaching? And if you allow part-time teaching, how many hours should they be? And again, if you allow part-time teaching of your staff, the staff in a particular school going to another school because it got across both now, so what is the workload that such a teacher should carry? Then what is the maximum? Now, we will look at the staff standard of living also, what comes into the staff, then the school community relationship. We'll look at the practical participation and involvement. Then you look at the school climate. In the area of school climate, you look at the area of discipline, you look at your relationship between teacher to teacher, student to teacher, even the community. How do they relate with student to student? How do they relate with one another? These are things that you require when you are looking at the data under the types of data you required in design and evaluating implementation strategy. Now, let us quickly look at the quantitative type that you require. We have looked at the qualitative, let's look at the quantitative that you require in the area of data and information. Now, we may need the type of education to be provided. For example, you may look at the formal and non-formal, technical and vocational. Then you look at the level of education, primary, secondary, tertiary, pre-primary even will come in, the monotechnic will come in, polytechnic universities will come in. Then you could think about the school ownership. Who owns the school? Do you want to popularize the private, state or federal? These are issues, or even missionaries, you can count it among the private sector. Then you look at the institutional data, school location, enrollment by cells, age, special student and school size. Now, data on personnel. You need to know the number of staff that you have in the school and what will be required in the school. Now, data on quality control. What are the mechanisms that will be put in place to control quality in a school? These are data that you will require when designing evaluation and implementation plan. You need data on the students, you need data on the school data. The school data will give you information on what record that is being kept in the school and data of finance. And that school data, we need to know who is the owner of the school, where was it founded, the date the school was founded, and what has the school been able to make in area. Then you look at the data of finance, the area of financing, the source of finance, how it is expended, accountability of that finance. Then the population data is equally required. Now, another area that is being looked at is the quantitative school-wise data. This is the school-wise data. The first quantitative we look at was not the school-wise, it was the system-wise data. But this is the school-wise data. And in the area of the school-wise data, you look, take up the number of days school was opened in an academic section. Then you look out for the average length of school day, enrollment by age, grade, and gender, teacher turnover rate, average teaching load per week. That is the workload of the teacher, the workload of the students. You need to look at all this. Average daily student attendance, the average teacher attendance by gender and grade, number of visitors by school inspectors. Then you have to, you have to talk about the number of visits by school inspectors, and we'll have to look at the student flow. The student flow through grades and the student flow through levels. These are areas that we really, really need to look at when you are to implement a plan. Now, another area is the collection of the required data and information. When you want to collect the required data or the information, what do? You have to look out for the source. What is the source that you're going to get your data? What method are you going to use? And what are the problems that surround the collection and the method? First of all, what problem do you want to solve? The what problems around the collection they solve. Because there are times you really need vital data, and the data will not be available because those are supposed to release the data, they are afraid. They feel that they don't want to release a secret or vital document in their establishment. And when this happens, it affects a plan.